Hello and welcome to Tutorials Point. In this video session, we will be learning third component of JUnit test framework, that is test runners. Now, to run the test case, the very first thing we need to do is write in different tests. The second thing we need to do is combine all the test cases in the test suites as per user or as per requirement of tester. After combining it into suites, we need to run it all along. And for to running all the test cases and test suites, we need test runner class, and it is used for executing all the test cases as per tester's requirement. So now we will see practically how actually test runners are being used to run different test cases. Let us see that how more than test cases can we run as test suite using test runner. So over here, for example, I have created two test cases, that is test1.java and test2.java. It is of JUnit, and I have created test methods for it with annotation @test. Over here we are getting idea in console that this test case is being executed. So when we'll have this result, it means this test case has been executed, our test suite execution. Same way, I have created test2.java. It is also having test method, and it is having one message that test2 is getting executed. So we can get idea that it has also been executed in our test suite execution. Now, to combine this both file and run it as test suite using test runner, you have to create one more file, that is testrun.java. That should be your class file with the method public static void main. You should be having one method, main method, in this file, which is not included in test JUnit files. So just right click on your project, click on new and click on class file. Give the required name to this class file and check this box, that is include public static void main method in that class. By doing so, your class file will be created over here. In this class file, we are creating one object of class result, that is result, in which our result will be lying of our test suite execution. So in this result, we need to run some classes of which we want to store the result. So whatever classes you want to run, you need to specify JUnit core dot run classes. It means we are extracting classes from the JUnit core framework, and you need to specify that which test case you want to execute. I want to execute test1.java and test2.java. So I need to give the class file of both. So I will be executing this two class file as test suite. Now, for result class, it will be consisting of failures also. So for each failure, you need to print some message. So for that, you need to write one for loop. Say for each failure of your result class, you need to write the failure string. That means if your test case is being failed, you'll be having the failure string in console. And if you are not having any failure in your test case, then your result will be successfully passed. So you will be having the successful print message. So let's see that how this test case will be combined as test suite using test runner class. So let's run this application. Just right click on test runner, click on run as, and click on Java application. It will be considered as Java application because it is having void main, it is not having any annotations of JUnit. That's why it will be run as Java application. Now your test 1 is executed, your test 2 is being executed, and the result is successful. That's why the true has been print. It means you didn't find any errors in this class. So this how we can execute test cases as test suite using test runner class. Thank you.